I want to, since Madhuri brought this up, I thought I would actually show this to you. When Madhuri was talking about all of the various chemicals that exist within a cigarette, a rough estimation is between 4,000 and 7,000 different chemicals based on, you know, what brand you're smoking. Having said that, there are four basic ingredients to vape e-juice, right? Which looks like this. So this e-juice has four things. It's about 60 to 70% vegetable glycerin, 25 to 30% propylene glycol, 5 to 15% flavoring, and 0 to 6% nicotine. This is what is the rough breakup. But according to this chart, vegetable glycerin within the pharmaceutical industry is used for heart medications, anesthetics, and cough syrups. Within the cosmetics industry, it's used for soaps, lotions, makeup, and deodorant. Within the food industry, it's used in frozen foods, baked goods, sauces, condiments, many more. Propylene glycol, same situation. Pharmaceutical industry, it's used in asthma medication, nebulizers, capsules, all of this since 1950. In the cosmetics industry, it's used in sunscreen, face cream, lipstick, so on and so forth. In the food industry, it's used in a lot of packaged food. It's used in mixed drinks, soft drinks, popcorn, food coloring, fast food, bread, and dairy products. Flavoring, the flavoring that is found in this e-liquid, is the same flavoring that is used for ice cream, candy, drinks, things like that. And nicotine. Nicotine is the big bad wolf. Because everybody says nicotine is harmful, nicotine is harmful, nicotine is toxic, nicotine is toxic. But like Madhuri was pointing out, nicotine is no more toxic than caffeine. And caffeine is in one of the most famous things that South India has ever produced, South Indian filter coffee. Caffeine. So imagine how you would be feeling as good South Indians if the government banned filter coffee because they said caffeine is bad for you. Would you agree with them? No. This is where we are right now. All of you would never agree with the government if the government said caffeine is bad, ban filter coffee. Because you know there's nothing wrong with it. You've been drinking filter coffee for 10 generations now and there's never been a problem. This is how we feel. We have all been vaping for anywhere between 5 and 3 years. We know what vaping has done for us. We know the health benefits. I know that I no longer have COPD. Madhuri is no longer ill. Right? We know this. But when you talk to the government and you ask them, how do you know that vaping is bad? What do they tell you? They don't give you scientific studies. They don't give you research. They don't give you first-hand information. They say, no, see, my friend's son's brother's sister's mother has some other friends and they are having some problems. Where are these people? Show me the people that are having problems. Those people don't exist. Those people are made up by some Bollywood, Collywood, Tollywood, because we've never seen them. We have so far never seen one person appear in a courtroom when the government is talking about how dangerous it is. We are appearing and we're saying it's not dangerous, please listen to me, trust me, let me give you my opinion. The government has not produced one person. In the last 2 years, 2.5 years that they've been fighting vaping, they have not produced one single person who has come forward and said, I was a vapor, I got very sick because of vaping. Not one. So then what is this information based on? If I tell you today that ice cream is bad because I once ate ice cream and I threw up, you will ask me, what else did you eat? How much ice cream did you eat? You will ask those questions, correct? Because everybody knows ice cream is not a problem. So then why can't we follow the same principle for everything else? India has around 1 million vapors. 1 million, right?
10 lakhs? 10 lakh people? Is a million 10 lakhs or 1 crore?
10 lakhs,
right? So 10 lakh vapors we have in this country. Has any government person asked even one of those vapors, tell me what is your story? No. So right now, it looks like the government says, I don't know anything about this, but I don't like it. How? How can you not like something that you don't know anything about? What is the story based on? So one news report somewhere, and the government says, okay, ban. 7 people died in America, let us ban vaping in India. What about the fact that in the UK, for example, and at some later point I will actually show you the picture. This was a picture that was taken by one of our members in the UK. He had gone to the hospital because he had hurt his leg. So he went to the hospital in the UK, and inside the hospital, there is a shop. And there are signs everywhere in the hospital saying, you cannot smoke on the premises. Please do not smoke on the premises. Please do not smoke next to patients. If you are a smoker, please go and get a vape. This is in the hospital in the UK. And here I can't vape outside the railway station. There they are vaping outside the hospital. They are vaping inside the hospital. Because they understand that yes, it might look like smoke, but it's not smoke. Right? This is the difference. Many times, and I'm sure all of us vapers have faced this, many times when we're out on the street somewhere, I might be vaping, and someone will come and tell me, ah, you're not smoking. Sir, I'm not smoking. This is a vape. Adala therile, but you can't do it. How? You don't know what it is, but you won't, but you know that I can't do it. Why? Because it looks like smoke. Right? Now imagine this situation. You have a man who's a terrible man. He's committed some murders, some crimes. Okay? There's another man who looks like him. So we'll take that man and put him in jail. We won't put the murderer in jail. We leave him because that murderer, I'm talking about his cigarettes, just in case that, right? So the cigarettes is the murderer. We leave the murderer free. You go, you do what you want, you kill people. The guy who looks like the murderer, we'll take him and put him in jail because Park Dikr, similar. That's not fair. That doesn't make any sense. It's this entire exercise is just, it is an exercise in pointlessness, and I'll tell you why. In the whole history of the world, there is not one example where prohibition has worked. Our very own Prime Minister's home state of Gujarat is a dry state. Has anyone been to Gujarat? I've been to Gujarat. You can get alcohol everywhere. Officially, it's not allowed. Unofficially, they'll come to your house and they'll deliver. You call them, you call the black market guy. You say, I want 10 bottles, 5 bottles, 8 bottles. He'll bring it and come to your house. So now, in Gujarat, like in Tamil Nadu, for example, the government, the largest revenue generator in the government is Tasman. In Gujarat, they don't make that money. Why? The bootleggers make that money. One of the largest revenue streams for the government in our country is tobacco. It's somewhere in the region of 300 to 400,000 crores is what the government makes on tobacco. Vaping? Now do you see why they don't like vaping? Because for every vapor that is created, one smoker is destroyed. So, 5 years ago, there were less than 100 vapors in the country. Less than 100 vapors 5 years ago. That number has now grown to slightly over 1 million vapors. That means 1 million people who used to buy cigarettes who now don't buy cigarettes. And then you have the government who comes back and says, all of you, go buy cigarettes. This is the problem. I don't want to buy cigarettes. I don't like the taste, I don't like the smell, I don't like anything. In fact, after smoking for 24 years, Today when I go to an airport and I want to vape and I have to go stand in the smoking area and vape, I stand as fast as I can and I leave. Because I don't like that smell. The whole point is, I know that that's bad for me, that's why I stopped doing it. But now you want me to go back to the same place and smoke someone and breathe someone's secondhand smoke, which I also know is bad for me, in order for me to do the less dangerous thing. How does this make sense? Everywhere else in the world, you can, like, we could be vaping right here. Perfectly legal, because it's not a problem. In fact, vaping was created for indoor use. That was the whole point of it. Was that you don't have to go and stand somewhere like an animal in a zoo, and everyone will walk past you. Yeah, you see, you've seen the looks that you get sometimes. One day, I was standing outside my bank. I was vaping. And I exhaled. I was on my phone. I exhaled. This lady walked out of the bank. She walked out. She saw the smoke. And immediately, first reaction. So I asked her, I said, "What happened, madam?" She said, "Illa, that's a bad smell." So I said, "Smell it first. I'm vaping mango. You don't like mango. How is that a bad smell?" This is the thing that I don't understand. It's a natural reaction. You see smoke, you think bad smell. Right? So, I was just telling Madhuri and Anand earlier today. One day I was in